Hi everyone, my name is Anson. I am a student from Taiwan. I'm part of the class of 2022. And today we're here to tell you about bioengineering. So what is bioengineering? As the name suggests, it's the combination of biology and engineering. It's the application of life sciences, physical sciences, mathematics, and other engineering principles. And the idea is that we want to solve problems in biology, medicine, healthcare, and other fields. For example, if you've ever heard of artificial hips, knees, or joints, these are examples of bioengineering projects and products. You can work in smaller scale cell structures, microscopic systems, things like bioremediation and waste treatment. And these are all part of the bioengineering field. And to do this, it means that we need to apply things like electronics, computer science, measurement principles to develop new tools for bioengineering issues in the daily world. And this is great because it means you get to collaborate with researchers in allied fields, doctors and dentists. It's overall a very collaborative, multidisciplinary field to work in. So what does a bioengineering major curriculum inside NYU Abu Dhabi look like? Well, it's quite similar to other engineering curriculums because it isn't under the engineering department, which means you do need 16 credits of mathematics. What's different is that bioengineering does require foundations of science 1 to 6. So most engineering only requires foundations of science 1 and 2, but bioengineering is a bit special just because they want students to understand more about biology, chemistry, and physics. So it's great to decide whether or not you want to do bioengineering starting in your sophomore year. And so some core bioengineering specific courses include fundamentals of bioengineering, biomechanics, biotransport, physical chemistry, bioengineering, and biomaterials. And if you're unsure whether or not you want to pursue bioengineering, I highly suggest students take fundamentals of bioengineering. This is an amazing course taught by Professor Rafael Song, and it touches upon all the bioengineering topics you will learn in your time here. It's a great intro course for any other bioengineering course, and there are no prerequisites. I think it will help students decide whether or not bioengineering is really your calling or not. Biomechanics, for instance, deals with bone structures, muscles, stress and strain, and biotransport deals with blood flow, a bit of anatomy, but it's mostly a class with mathematics and how to apply mathematics inside science. All of these bioengineering courses are really great because they're all very small, 3 to 8 students per class. That makes it very discussion-based and you get very close to your peers and also your professors. So I think bioengineering courses are some of the best courses I've taken so far in our school. My most memorable class and assignment is I took computer programming for engineers my first semester here. It's a huge class of like 100 students. You get put into small groups of I think 3 to 4 students at the time. Our assignment was that we had to make a robotic arm that could detect our hand movements, and then the robotic arm would do the exact same hand movement simultaneously. The reason it's memorable isn't because we did a great job, it was because we did a very horrible job. Our robotic arm wasn't working. We went up to present it and we kind of made it look like it was working even though it wasn't. I'm pretty sure the professor saw it and knew that it wasn't working, which is kind of embarrassing. We ended up somehow getting a really good grade. I'm not sure how. I think he saw the effort and time. We felt pretty embarrassed, and I think a lot of people who were in the audience saw that our robotic arm wasn't actually working and they were laughing, and I think that was just extremely memorable and a great experience. And I definitely don't suggest that you go up and present something that's not working and that's like a half done job. Extremely memorable and a great experience. Although the professor for the robotic arm project class knew that we didn't finish the project, he ended up making me the TA for the class. And so I've been the TA for the class for 2 years now, and I've also been working in this lab for 3 years now. There's a lot of nice professors out there, and if you go out and put some time to meet them and show them you're interested, show them that you care and you want to put a good job and help them with their research or understand more about the field, they're willing to help you as well. If you have the time and effort, please do reach out to professors and understand more about them. That's one of my all-time favorite advice to give any first year. And especially in engineering where you do a lot of research, I think this is a great thing to do early on in your career here at NYU Abu Dhabi. How hardcore is bioengineering in our school? This is a very subjective question, so I will give a very subjective response. I think bioengineering at NYU Abu Dhabi is about a 7 out of 10 in difficulty. Here's why. We have to do foundations of science 1 to 6. I would give that a 7 to 8 in difficulty. Foundations of science is high workload, a lot of energy and time spent in foundations of science. Obviously, if you put the time and energy, it's not going to be too bad, but it is relatively difficult in my opinion. The bad news is also I think that mathematics is quite difficult. Courses like MVC, linear algebra, ODE, probability and statistics, these are math requirements that I find to be quite challenging and hard. Personally, I learned math in high school based on formulas and application of seeing who can calculate the fastest, who can calculate the most in a certain amount of time inside NYU Abu Dhabi. It's quite conceptual, quite abstract. But the good news is that the bioengineering specific courses that I talked about, biomechanics, fundamentals, bioimaging, biomaterials, these courses are like a 5 to 6 in difficulty. I find them to be much easier than math courses and foundations of science. So that's why I think that overall, a 7 out of 10 in difficulty. What are bioengineering exams like? I'm gonna go over what a bioengineering course could look like and what can be involved in the grading process. In most bioengineering courses, there are labs. These are weekly labs. You go to the lab, you do some experimentation, you collect some data, you go back and write down a simple lab report. So these are mostly short assignments. They won't be too long or too difficult. And they're mostly just small checkpoints for the professor to know how well you're doing in the class and if you're really understanding the concepts that we're teaching in lectures. Most courses in bioengineering do have exams, and they're usually midterms and finals. Because they are 7-week courses, you won't expect many exams, maybe 2 exams at most. And in these courses, there's not really a lot of presentations, so it's mostly lecture-based and exam-based. Best of all, there's no essays for bioengineering courses, which is great because I personally hate writing essays. I'm a student who likes to attend lectures, listen, go back and do a bit of studying and take an exam. So I think that I'm having a great time in bioengineering personally. That said, you do have to put effort. Bioengineering courses aren't an easy A, but my experience is that if you do put the time and effort into studying, you can get an A in these courses. Everyone is different, so some people might find it easier, some people might find it harder, but I can assure you that these courses won't require you to do a lot of constant studying. So there are many school activities that are relevant to bioengineering. So I'll go over one competition, one society, and one SIG that I'll talk about. Number one is iGEM. So this is a competition that's held every year. iGEM stands for International Genetically Engineered Machine, and students get into groups of 20, 30, 40 students, and they work over the summer and into the semester to produce a bioengineering solution to an issue in the world. A lot of students end up flying to Boston with the school and present their findings there, and they've won awards in the past, and I think it's a great initiative. And a lot of them have a great time in Boston, I've heard, so that's a big plus, I think. One society I want to talk about is the Biomedical Engineering Society on campus. So there is a society for bioengineering students. It's mostly for Professor Song and the president of the SIG to kind of introduce students to any professionals, any industry experts in the field within Abu Dhabi. So they come and give talks, or they discuss with students about bioengineering and their career aspects and aspirations. And I think it's a society that anybody can join. And one SIG I want to talk about is the Pre-Health Advisory Board. I've been personally involved in the Pre-Health Advisory Board. It's for students in bioengineering or biology or any other field to explore what a pre-health pathway looks like. There's many events like talking to doctors, medical experts, and even it can give you some opportunities in research on what do you want to do for bioengineering or what do you want to do when you graduate there. So I think these are three experiences that I've seen students do that are really relevant to bioengineering as a major. What are some important skill sets that every bioengineering student should have? There are two I want to talk about. The first one is attention to detail, and the second one is mathematics. I want to say mathematics because bioengineering and engineering as a whole is quite math intensive in my opinion. In your entire engineering time here, you will be using a lot of mathematics. So whether in circuits or like bioengineering courses or statics or dynamics, you will need to use differentiation, integration, and basic solving of two linear equations. You will be doing a lot of mathematics, so you might make some mistakes, and ideally you don't want to. To solve a circuit problem, you need to write a lot of linear equations. And the idea is that sometimes when you mess up a positive or negative sign within your equations, you might mess up your entire working and your final answer and lose some points there. These two in combination are quite important because in any bioengineering course or any engineering core curriculum course, mathematics and attention to detail is quite important, and they go hand in hand. You really shouldn't not have any of these skills in my opinion, so. But if you're not good at it, don't stress. You have time in your first year to learn and, you know, to experience more. And I think that you may be put on the right track over time. What advice for freshmen would I give who are interested in bioengineering? My first advice is that please do well on your math placement test. When I first came, I knew that math placement test was quite important regardless of which engineering you're doing. Some people might tell you that, oh, it's not important, enjoy your summer. You should enjoy your summer. I'm not saying you shouldn't, but I'm saying that you should really, really try your best to get placed into calculus and MBC because these math levels will make an impact into your career here in NYU Abu Dhabi. Enjoy your summer, but also please study. I'm sure that you will receive an email sometime before coming to NYU Abu Dhabi if you're a first year about what's covered in the math placement test. There's also courses online in the student portal that you should check out, definitely. Do the courses and look through the questions and kind of familiarize yourself over the summer break. Try your best, don't give up. I know a lot of students will come in the exam and write their name and then say, I'm not doing sciences, I'm not doing mathematics, and they walk right out, or I'm not doing economics or some social science courses, so they're not interested in doing the math placement test, but for you, it's quite important. Make sure you learn things like the McLaurin and Taylor series. I'm not sure if these are the same topics they've had in the past. Try to learn them as well as possible if you can. And my second advice is take Fundamentals of Bioengineering with Professor Rafael Song. So this course is offered every semester, a really, really great introductory course for any student who wants to explore bioengineering. It's a great chance for you to know what other courses you'll be taking down the road, what it's like, if you like the field, if you're interested in a career there. And I think it's a very holistic course that's taught by a great professor. I would say the last advice is take Computer Programming for Engineers. Computer Programming for Engineers is a first year course that's offered in the fall every year. And it's to teach students how to program and code. And I think this is a great introduction inside engineering as well. So these are my three advice for any student who's interested in bioengineering. So one tidbit I want to add on for any student, not just bioengineering students, but as general advice, I think that there's a lot of clout in our school about how you shouldn't take easy course or colloquiums or take easy courses outside of your major. People do give you a lot of crap about not, can I say that? People do give you a lot of hard time if you don't take the hardest courses or the most challenging courses to challenge yourself. My opinion is that I think if you're doing a schedule that's extremely difficult, a lot of high workload, very hardcore major, I think it's fine, you know? I think it's fine to take some easier courses to relax, chill out a little bit, and to focus your energy and time into hard courses that matter. Because at the end of the road, when you do apply to grad school, medical school, or whatever school you want to apply to, law school, they really do only mostly care about the classes that are relevant to the major or to the field. So when people tell you to take the most challenging courses, to take the hardest courses, I say, you know what, it's fine. I don't think anybody should be put down for taking easier courses. Maybe I'm guilty of doing so, but I think that it really gave me the opportunity to put time and energy into the courses that do matter, doing research that matters, and maybe doing some volunteering as well. So listen to what your heart tells you or what I tell you, and that's one of the big pieces of advice I can give anybody. How would I envision my career in bioengineering to look like? I hope to one day work in a bioengineering firm that can make surgical robots or tools, trying to investigate how we can put engineering and technology in the application of health sciences to improve medical treatments and stuff like that. I do have to say that when I graduate, I'm looking into some health fields, maybe medicine, dentistry, or nursing. I'm not quite sure yet, but again, like I said earlier, bioengineering is the perfect opportunity for any student who doesn't know if they like engineering or health fields to explore both fields and to finish some requirements. It leaves a lot of options open for the future. In the case of going to a bioengineering firm, applying engineering into medicine is a field with great promise. If you look online, there's a lot of new companies, a lot of new industries and innovation within applying engineering to medicine. There's a huge market for this in the future. For instance, detecting cancer using AI or some kind of photographic technique, performing laparoscopic surgery with robots like the Da Vinci surgical robots. And this is just generally a big field and big trend towards this. So bioengineering is a great field to go into right now. And I think that it will get better in the future. So hopefully that helps give you some motivation and encouragement into going to bioengineering. If I become a freshman again, would I still choose bioengineering? And to that question, I have to say a big yes. When I first came to NYU Abu Dhabi, I was unsure whether or not I wanted to do engineering or do a pre-med track, so like in biology or chemistry. Bioengineering is the only engineering major that allows you to complete your pre-health requirements. So if you want to apply to medical, dental, nursing school in the future, and also complete an engineering degree in 4 years. So I think it's a great opportunity for me to balance both of these needs and then decide later on when I graduate what I want to do in the future. I think that anybody who in a similar boat as me who wants to probably maybe one day go to medical, dental school, or nursing school, bioengineering is a great pathway for you to do so. And you get to learn a lot of things and how to apply a lot of engineering and a lot of technology within biology or chemistry or any health sciences. I genuinely enjoy bioengineering courses. I met a lot of great professors here, like Professor Song. He's a really great guy who takes care of his students and cracks a lot of dad jokes. He's really great, and I think that he kind of inspired me to pursue bioengineering. He gave me a lot of encouragement, a lot of motivation. People like Professor Kasami, you know, care a lot about students as well. And if you reach out to them, I guarantee you'll almost always have a great experience and they'll be super accommodating to you a lot of times. That said, most professors are like this. I've met some professors that are really a pain. You will inevitably encounter them, but I guess that's really the part of the college experience. Like, you never get a perfect professor, a perfect class. But what I can say is that if you put time and effort, I'm sure any professor, any person will see your effort and time. And again, bioengineering has been a great experience for me so far. And I think that if I were to start again, yes, I would do it without skipping a heartbeat. One big final advice I want to give any student who wants to do bioengineering is that please do reach out to me or any professor in bioengineering. Bioengineering is an extremely, extremely new major. So I'm the class of 2022. I think alongside two of my other friends, we will be the first generation to graduate with bioengineering degrees. So please do reach out. Don't be afraid to ask upperclassmen about questions that you might think, oh, might be dumb. But I think we were once, you know, first year, we were once dumb students too. So, you know, there's no dumb questions. Clarify anything you want to clarify with us. You know, reach out to us because we're here to help. We've been through the process. We know it can be very, very daunting at first. And I know that a lot of students come to this campus unsure about what they want to do. And maybe talking to us, having a lunch with us would really help decide whether or not you want to do bioengineering. There's not a lot of bioengineering students currently right now, but I know that there's more and more coming in and more students interested. If you're unsure, yeah, just ask. Please do like, subscribe, and comment down below if you have any questions or anything. I know that NYUAD's channel has a lot of great things coming for you guys, and there's campus tours, there's other majors, so please do check out her other videos. I think they're great, and there's not many vloggers or YouTubers on campus, so she's kind of starting everything from scratch, so please do enjoy your time here. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and you know more about bioengineering, and you know what you want to do in the future, maybe, possibly. Thanks for listening, and bye-bye!